Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi barakatuhu, everybody. Good morning, good morning. Let me go ahead and just get started here real quick, just a sec. All right, bismillah. So as we enter this sixth session, it's already been six sessions, alhamdulillah, we've covered 15 names so far. And one verse of the Quran, I believe we may have mentioned in a previous session, but one I wanted to lift up for us as we continue these sessions and as we go through just what these sessions are for. We remember now in the Quran, it's stated, and just one moment here. Okay, perfect. So just in the Quran, as it's stated that, O ye who believe, fasting is prescribed for you as it was prescribed for those before you, that you may develop God consciousness. This the root is of taqwa, of this not necessarily just directly a fear of God, but an awareness, a heightened awareness of God, a mindfulness of God. And this is what these sessions hope to incorporate, is the mindfulness that we experience, that mindfulness that we remember with God. So yesterday we covered al-musawwir, the one who shapes, al-ghafar, the forgiving, and Al-Qahhar, the one who overcomes. And through these names, we lifted up the concepts of what do we shape in our everyday lives? What do we forgive? Who do we forgive? How do we treat others? And how do we overcome our struggles? And so these names, as transcendent as they are and as all-encompassing as they are calls for us to internalize and to then take what is given to us, the shaping, the forgiving, the overcoming, and to incorporate that into our own lives and how we treat one another and how we treat ourselves especially. So with that being said, we're going to continue into our next three names today, which are Al-Wahhab, Al-Razzaq, Al-Fattah. But before we do, we will do a recitation, as always, of the 99 names. So just a moment here. All right. And as always, as you are comfortable and as you get into a space and center, just recognize these names. You don't have to know all of them. You don't have to memorize all of them or the tune or anything like that. Just this is how we'll start our space. This is how we start our day, inshallah. We'll try to incorporate this at the close now, just based on some feedback we've gotten. But just get yourself in a space where you can hear these names and you can maybe see them on screen if you look at the translation, but just get that space there. So bismillah, we'll begin. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم المالك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر الخالق البارئ المصور الغفار القهار الوهاب الرزاق الفتح العليم القابض الباسط الخافض الرافع المعز المذل السميع البصير الحكم العدل اللطيف الخبير الحليم العظيم الغفور الشكور العلي الكبير الحفيظ المقيت الحسيب الجليل الكريم الرقيب المجيب الواسع الحكيم الودود المجيد الباعث الشهيد الحق الوقيل القوي المتين الولي الحميد المحسي المبدي المعيد المحيي المميت الحي القيوم الواجد الماجد الواحد الأحد الصمد القادر المقدر المقتدر المقدم المؤخر الأول الآخر الظاهر الباطن الوالي المتعالي البر التواب المنتقم العفو الرؤوف مالك الملك ذو الجلال والإكرام المقسط الجامع الغني المغني الماني الضار نافع النور هادي البديع الباقي الوارث الرشيد الصبور. So let us begin today with the three names that we had lifted up at the beginning of the session, the Al-Wahhab, Al-Razzaq, and Al-Fattah. And you heard them as well in the recitation here. Al-Wahhab refers to, is translated as the bestower, the dispenser of all mercies, the giver of gifts. And Al-Wahhab comes from this root of giving, donating, you know, just according, presenting, endowing, and also the flip side of accepting a gift without having any kind of feeling of obligation. So this just really like this just mutual gift giving that is, you know, surrounding this. And Al-Wahhab is the one who gives steadily, but gives lavishly and gives without moderation. So these are the one things here that you see that's without moderation is this concept of giving something good, giving these gifts, and it's without any kind of limits. And you probably think of your closest family member, closest friend who always just gives things, gives and gives and gives. And it stems from this type of beauty, this aspect. And Al-Wahhab is the one who surrounds the creation with these gifts and blessings without expecting any specific gift back in return, except that recognition, except in terms of just that remembrance, that these gifts are a source of remembrance and not just that now you have to give a gift. It's a very simple exchange that's there. But at the end of the day, nothing is necessarily needed, and not the one who gives the gift, Al-Wahhab, is not deprived of anything if you don't give anything in return. It's only the loss of you who receives the gift if you do not give that. And so Al-Wahhab is to give a truly free gift, but without expectations. And it is also the name of the one who, apart from forever giving these gifts, is the one who forever gives, and the giver of opportunities, the giver of visible, invisible, the one in this world and the hereafter. And what this name helps us recognize in our time as Al-Wahhab, as the giver, is these possessions that we have, everything around us that we've been given, the clothes on our back, anything that you can name, the physiological gifts we may have, any type of things we've gotten, these are all possessions that are a gift. These have been given to us by Al-Wahhab, the one who's bestowed. And ultimately, it tells us of our reliance on God. If we start to see each of the things that we have as but possessions that have been gifted to us by God, we start to see where they came from. We start to have an appreciation for where we get all of this, as opposed to thinking that, oh, I, because of my efforts, I was able to buy this, I was able to do this, I was able to do this, and creating that barrier between you and God, which inevitably comes in our current society, that we just build one thing on another, and we make that separation between us and God, especially when we see how much of the things around us come from God. And so what we can incorporate from this is that if we really just cover ourselves in gratefulness, if we really internalize gratefulness, we're in a position to recognize those blessings. If we're in a position of lifting up the ego, lifting up our arrogance, we will be absent-minded of these blessings. And so the difference between the one who can see these blessings and the one who can't see it is, in fact, that peace in one's heart. The peace in one's heart to recognize that they're satisfied with whatever they've been given, and the ability to then be nurtured by life in the different circumstances that we might face. And the just essential aspect of this is that you are then able to be shaped by the world around you, and you're able to be changed for more God consciousness because you're at a heightened sense of awareness of what's around you, who it's from, whose it is and whose it's from. And you are not in a position, in a sense, to think of yourself as better, think of yourself as more. You don't have that Fir'aun mentality when it comes to what is all is around you. And so the love that is manifested through Al-Wahhab draws its gift from abundance. It's just coming from an endless source. And Al-Wahhab, in terms of when we internalize it, when we recognize it, we see the abundance. We just really start to see how much of this is really a gift. Because sometimes if we just ask someone, hey, name like the blessings in your life, name something that's good, they can probably count, on their life just because they name those things. They're specifically thinking that, oh, you know, my car, my this, my that, whatever it might be. But as Allah tells us, you know, which of the favors of your Lord can you deny? And if you were to count the blessings of your Lord, you'd never be able to name them. Because of this, is that it gets you back into that zone that, oh, I really can't name them, because you think about what all is actually there that I can be grateful for. And with this name, humans are able to give as well. So we're able to give and be givers, regardless of the response that may or may not follow. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives beyond any measure. But as I mentioned, not for anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala needs from us. You know, it's not anything that will take away from Al-Wahhab or Allah if we don't respond back to the gift. The gift keeps on coming in different ways. And we sometimes will just not recognize that it's there, it's coming to us. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't lose anything if we don't take in that gift. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just asks of us to be mindful and to remember where we got this gift from. But even if we don't do that, it doesn't take away anything from Allah. It takes away something from us. But as humans, then, if we incorporate that quality, we then also are not only able to give beyond our measure, but the response that we might get, if it's something positive, if we give a gift to somebody, let's say we have a fight or we have a dispute or something, and we want to seek forgiveness with that person and we want to reconcile with that person, oftentimes we want to give them a gift, or we want to do something that makes it look like we made it up to them, or that we're trying to make things up and patch things up. But maybe they don't respond favorably. Maybe they don't repair that friendship as well. Maybe they don't say thank you for this gift or anything like that. They just probably say thanks and that's it, and you don't hear from them ever again. That shouldn't take away from you giving that gift, because you recognize that you gave that gift as under that substance of Al-Wahhab. And Al-Wahhab, apart from giving that gift, does it without any expectation of getting anything back. So just being mindful of this in terms of the God consciousness that can come about, and what can come about in the awareness when we just look at our surroundings and we recognize it not of our doing, but as the gift of God to be able to even do it. There are so many of us who are not in that position to be able to have any of this. So even if it's like a book on your shelf here that collects complete dust and it's just sitting there, the fact that you have been in a position, the book is not just a gift, but your ability to have gotten that book there, your ability to have gotten, if not a job, or if in a sense, like to get a place to hold the bookshelf. So there's so many things that build upon this, that when you start to think about where are your gifts, gifts aren't just tangible things that you can hold and you can enumerate or you can put on a tax deductible list. Your gifts are things that have also been imbued internal, as we mentioned. They're the ones that are visible and invisible. So being mindful of what our gifts are that are there. So next, this name is then connected to the name Ar-Razzaq. Ar-Razzaq is the one who looks after all beings, the provider, the nurturer. If you have like a 99 names of Allah chart, it's probably listed as the provider. It's a very popular name that's there, but it's what the name connotates is provision. And it provides human beings with not only their livelihood, but also everything they need for the material and the spiritual life. Gratefulness manifests when we become providers and nurturers for those around us who might be hungry, or those around us who might be dependent on us. We get this this sense of gratefulness. And Ar-Razzaq is that divine quality that really lies within us. And it makes us realize that we really do participate in the shaping of this world, because when we give of our provision, we see how much of a difference we can make when we do it intentionally and when we do it sincerely. So when you're a part of social justice, when you're a part of just different environmental activism, or just communal repair, or whatever it may be, communal work, you can see the tangible difference you make when you not just, you know, give the like some extra that you have, but when you give a provision, when you really provide for someone, you are helping meet their needs. So often will we, you know, go to the corner of a street and see someone standing there, and, you know, just speaking for myself here, and sometimes, you know, sometimes we'll just give like a dollar or give like a water bottle or something, and the person will, you know, they'll express their gratitude, but thinking about, what do they need? Like right now, they don't have a home to go to. Right now, they don't have probably a full meal. Like, what do they need? Am I really being a provider at that point? Or am I just satisfying just like a small need of thirst? So the provision, the provider is one who provides to the point that you are satisfied, to the point to where you have been provided for. So if I come to your lunchtime and I just give you like a date, or I just give you just a bottle of water, and you're expecting a meal, have you really been provided for? So just, this is on the case of the provider, that the provider provides in that sense, the one who receives it, of course, you know, if received in a manner that has satisfied it, you know, would be grateful, but just understanding the circumstance as well, that we have an obligation to the folks around us who don't have enough or who are maybe dependent on us, that it's our obligation to help provide for them wholly and not just, you know, one token thing here and there. And so what this name also means, and when it connotates, it's also the one who not only provides, but nurtures all beings. It's the all-sustainer. The body is nurtured with the material food, the rizq, the provision that is provided, but the soul and the spirit is provided with that spiritual knowledge, that spiritual food that's given in, the comfort, the sakina, that is the tranquility that is bestowed by God. So this name helps us not, like the previous one, not ignore the flow of blessings that surround you. And the root of this word, ar-Razzaq, really comes from this concept of giving, as al-Wahhab does, but also parting with material and spiritual goods, having these different talents, and then nurturing oneself, becoming successful, but also then reciprocating and giving it to the world around. So this cultivation of goodness, and then to subsequently give it out, but parting with material and spiritual goods. So seeing that this is a material provision, this is a risk, but it's not just for me. This, you have a consciousness now that it's for somebody else as well. And so then you can flip the script and take what you've been given and give to other people. And so, as I mentioned, the concept of risk, of provision, it denotes everything that is good and useful to us, whether it's physical, in terms of water, food, clothing, shelter, or mental, in terms of any kind of just stability or calm or tranquility, or spiritual, in terms of just remembrance of Allah, or anything like that, that's any kind of reminders of Allah. And it concerns exclusively positive things and useful things. It never concerns things that are physically, morally, or socially disgracing or reprehensible or harmful. Any risk that's given, anything that's given in that connotation is positive, even if it's as sour as a grapefruit, it's positive in that sense, but it's not something that will degrade you, your humanity, or anything like that. And Allah supports all beings, regardless, not just humans, not just the other creations, but all beings. But it is our responsibility as humans, as people who've been appointed akin to a khalifa, akin to caretakers of this planet, of the world around us. It's our responsibility to then take the provision we've been given, and then to sow and to irrigate the earth and our communities and all that surrounds us, to then subsequently not just help them sustain themselves, but also to look after our sustenance. So we have a twofold relationship, that we are dependent on the creation. The creation may be dependent on us, but we want to make it a mutual relationship in which we're not just having a parasitic relationship of feeding off of one and not the other. This name helps us remember that we've been provided for. So let us then provide for the world around us, but also let's provide to ourselves, not exhausting ourselves in this time. And so we see that rich connection it has with al-Wahhab. And lastly, what comes about both of these names is really beautifully summed in al-Fattah. Al-Fattah refers to Allah as the opener, the one who reveals, the one who separates. Allah offers us a path of liberation through peace, a path of just opening our hearts and removing any of these constrictions through a peaceful mindfulness. And three meanings come from this divine name: opening, beginning, and success. So So in a process that opens the opening part refers to opening up of these dead end situations we might find ourselves caught up in, that we might be in these different difficulties, and we start to open up ourselves to different possibilities. We start opening ourselves up to the generosity and the relief that Allah brings in that we might look over. So we start to open up to things that might have become previously hardened, closed, or contracted. We often hear that the hearts have been hardened, that these things have been hardened. So opening is a process. There's always something that has to be done to open something. If it's pushing a button, if it's pushing a door, if it's turning a knob, if it's just doing whatever it might be, it requires some kind of initial push. So Allah is the one that opens, but we've got to be also the one that helps make that push. But Allah enables that as well. So as I mentioned, in our life, there are things that will regardless harden up or get constricted and tied into knots. You can think about that happening on a material level with work, with friends, family members, relationships, things getting into a bind, things not working out, your job coming into a rut, any things like that. But sometimes it happens on the level of the heart, where it manifests in areas of sorrow, in the areas of grief. Someone passes away and it's something you can't move on with, and worries. And then, or on the level of the mind as well. Remember, we talked about Ramadan is not just about your soul or your spirit. It's about mind, body, and soul. And then on the level of the mind, it takes form of these permanent doubts. It takes form of all these, you know, different questions that you might be having and doubting yourself, and so many things kind of coming up in your mind that really just keep you tied down, or you're overthinking something, or you're just, you know, stuck into something there. You feel like you're trapped in a situation. And so to some of us, Allah opens up the doors of knowledge that we can learn and we can transmit. And then for others of us, Allah will open up the doors of material or wealth that we may then subsequently not only provide for ourselves and our families, but also to help the world around us. And others, that strength and that health in those times where your mind is in knots, your heart's in knots, that we may subsequently help heal our own knots, help heal our own wounds, and then help heal the ones who are wounded and in need around us. And on your own, we open the doors of kindness. We open the doors of hope and compassion to human beings so that Al-Fattah not only helps you open these things, but then helps open the space for you and helps open such a new door for you to become something even more than you were before. And so, as I mentioned, the root of this word is it derives from opening, from activating, to building, to digging, to really going in deep, but then opening up to then blossom, to conquer, enlighten. These are all in that root of Al-Fattah. And Al-Fattah is the key that opens the heart to Allah. So let's pray that we find Allah in us, as well as what is around us. And that when things remain open, we start to love freely. We start to see that beauty of the provisions. This name ties back to Ar-Razzaq, Al-Wahhab, because we see the gifts, we see the provisions, we see these things, and our heart is open to receiving them, but our heart is open to recognizing them. And so these names work in tangent. And as I mentioned, this name helps counter self-reproach. Nafs al-lawama, that hating of ourselves, that this Al-Fattah is a quality that is a quality of love that help people in that state, as well as help those people not just in that state recover at that moment, but also then help everything that's around them. So as we close out today, before we do the dhikr, just to lift up that these names are not mutually exclusive. These specific names that we have, Al-Wahhab, Ar-Razzaq, Al-Fattah, Al-Wahhab, again, the one that is providing, that gives the gifts, that are the gift giver beyond any measure, and the one that has no measure to these gifts. And then Ar-Razzaq, the one that provides the exact amount that you need, the provider for things spiritual as well as material. And then Al-Fattah, the opener, and these things tying together to not just make us mindful of the gifts we've been given, but being mindful of the gifts we have to then give to the world around us and to see everything around us as a remembrance and recognition of Allah. So bismillah, we will conclude on on these three names and pick up the next three names tomorrow, but we will transition to our dhikr portion. And then again, the last part of the dhikr will actually just incorporate the Asma'il Husna for those of you interested. And yeah, let us go ahead and begin here. Just a second here. Bismillah. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. Al-Wahhab, 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 Al-Wahhab. Al-Wahhab, 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 Al-Wahhab. Ya Wahhab, 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 Ya Wahhab. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. Ar-Razzaq, 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 Ar-Razzaq. Ar-Razzaq, 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 Ar-Razzaq. Ya Razzaq, 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 Ya Razzaq. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. Al-Fattah, 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 Al-Fattah. Al-Fattah, 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 Al-Fattah. Ya Fattah, 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 Ya Fattah. La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, Allah, Allah, Allah. So may we incorporate these names in our everyday routines, and we're mindful of what the names are, what we've been given, and what we may see in the world around. So again, I'm just going to share my screen. We're going to close out with the Asma al-Husna, and we'll conclude from there. So, Bismillah. Sorry. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم المالك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر الخالق الباري المصور الغفار القهار الوهاب الرزاق الفتاح العليم القابض الباسط الخافض الرافع المعز المذل السميع البصير الحكم العدل اللطيف الخبير الحليم العظيم الغفور الشكور العلي الكبير الحفيظ المقيت الحسيب الجليل الكريم الرقيب المجيب الواسع الحكيم الودود المجيد الباعث الشهيد الحق الوكيل القوي المتين الولي الحميد المحسي مبدي المعيد المحيي المميت الحي القيوم الواجد الماجد الواحد الأحد الصمد القادر المقتدر المقدم المؤخر الأول الآخر الظاهر الباطن الوالي المتعالي البر التواب المنتقم العفو الرؤوف مالك الملك ذو الجلال والإكرام. المقسط الجامع الغني المغني الماني الضار النافع النور الهادي البديع الباقي الوارث الرشيد الصبور. Again, Jazakallah khair. Thank you for coming. Sorry about the little tech difficulty there. I don't know why the PowerPoint wasn't advancing, but I hope you have a blessed day. If you're fasting, if you're not fasting in Ramadan, just the one thing we take away from this session, being mindful of what we've been given, being mindful of what we have, and being mindful of what we can do. So Jazakallah khair for coming. And Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.